Look around. How do you know you can trust what you see? All you seem to be able to trust is that you can see it. What are we? How can we prove that we are, in fact, biological life? Why in this vast universe does it seem like we're the only intelligent life in our galaxy? Or maybe even the entire universe? Is it because we're living in a computer simulation? As crazy as this sounds, this is actually a heavily debated question. Even one Elon Musk believes this could be true. I mean, the technology already exists, so how can we be sure we aren't? In this Sci-5, I present 5 reasons we are living in a computer simulation. Number 5. Are paranormal events glitches? Even the greatest video games and computer applications have much-needed bug fixes. You get them all the time on your phone every time an app updates. If you look at the log, you can often find bug fix. If you play a video game long enough, you are bound to run into a point where something distorts with the character, or maybe even the music. But what is a bug in the program? A bug is an error in the coding that results in a flaw in the program. If we are living in a computer simulation, it would be nearly impossible for there to never be a flaw. So why haven't we noticed? Well, maybe we have. There are countless amounts of paranormal stories dating back thousands of years. Figures and shadows are known to wander the halls of old buildings, voices can be heard in strange forests, things fall over when no one is around. We generally assume this is the result of the paranormal, but what if instead these are just glitches in our program, simply bugs in the code of our system? And to steal from the movie we're all thinking of, The Matrix offered the idea that another glitch could be deja vu. So if there are glitches in the system, why wouldn't there be more prominent ones? Glitches that would make us notice instantly that something was wrong, like a building disappearing or a person freezing. We probably would notice that, and we may have already. But like any great test subject, we wouldn't be able to continue if we knew exactly what was going on. So with that in mind, would whoever or whatever is running the system let us keep that memory? Of course not. If something that disastrous happened, surely the program operators would erase the memory and fix the glitch. To continue on that, if we were ever able to find out that we were a part of the system, we wouldn't know it for long before the operators erased the memory. Number 4. Mathematical laws in our universe. For science fiction lovers, physicists, and probably anyone in the world who wishes time travel is possible, mathematical rules can be quite a setback. As far as scientists know now, we won't be traveling anywhere at hyperspeed, and time travel really is out of the question. All thanks to the mathematical and physical rules that make up our universe. But why have such strict rules? Life surely isn't black and white, so why are these laws? Well, there is another place where these types of laws are unbreakable, where they make up the very fabric of the entire system. Computers. When arguing in favor of the computer simulation theory, Max Tegmark, a cosmologist at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, stated, "If I were a character in a computer program, I would also discover eventually that the rules seemed completely rigid and mathematical. That just reflects the computer code in which it was written." And this makes complete sense. To anyone who writes programs and codes, you know the framework is very strict rules, and this is eerily similar to the universe that we inhabit. Unfortunately, that means, at least in this version of the simulation, there is most likely no way we will ever travel time or teleport, or be able to travel through the galaxy faster than the speed of light. But perhaps, in another parallel simulation, we are already doing all of that, as the mathematical rules are just a tad less boring. And with that comment? Number 3. Parallel universes. In my last video, we went over the signs parallel universes do exist. So let's say we take that as fact and apply it to this theory as well. In the concept of a simulation, parallel universes would be a great way to test the different possible outcomes and variations of a simulation. The programmers could make each of the parallel universes basically the same with only subtle differences, like what if JFK never got shot, and test out the different outcomes. Or perhaps things could be completely different. For instance, what we talked about in the last segment, the mathematical rules. Everything we speculate about the makeup of our universe when it comes to the multiverse theories and the bubble universe could be a part of a master program made up to test the different possibilities of whatever the programmers please. And for those who search for the purpose and reason behind everything, this theory gives reason to the multiverse. To ride off my last video a bit more, and to connect to the first segment of this video, The stories I told of people waking up in different universes, the Montauk Project, and even the doorway to another dimension could all be glitches that open up a connection between the other simulations running on top of each other. So maybe there is another you that just happened to be programmed in a world where all your dreams come true, or one where absolutely nothing good happens to you, all just to test your reactions and different outcomes. And this point leaves as a great segue to my next point. Number two, not everything is real. A universe as massive as ours would take incredible processing power to keep running, so programmers would likely make many shortcuts to decrease the load on their processors. This is where fake scenery, fake animals, and even fake people come into play. As complex as our universe seems to be, the simulation running it could actually be incredibly simple with the help of a few tricks. For starters, people. How many people that you see in a day do you actually interact with? If you don't interact with them, how can you prove they're real? Well, you can't. They may very well be images projected to make it seem like there are more people in the world than there actually is. But what if we took that even further? What if everyone except for you is a pre-programmed illusion meant for you and you alone to interpret? What if nothing other than your own perception of the universe is real? Speaking in programming terms, with less variables, the code would be much simpler to write. And without knowing what the programmers are truly in search of, you can't be sure anything or anyone else is real. Let's just say that that isn't the case. Maybe all humans exist as variables within the simulation. This makes the whole system much more complex. So, what tricks would be used to decrease the load in this case? Do you ever wonder if the observable universe is real? Since we can't, at least for now, actually go there, we can't technically prove it is real. Instead, to save processing power, the images and information we have gathered could very well be an illusion to trick us into thinking there is more out there, when in whatever version of reality we are living in, it doesn't exist. This could apply anywhere the programmers could cut corners. Animals could be fake, landscapes could be fake, the Earth's core even. And to really save power, none of these things could even be running in the simulation when your eyes are closed, or when you're asleep. It's only when you look or interact with something that it actually exists. Number one, God is a programmer. Whether it be a single god or many gods, for nearly as long as humans have existed, there has been belief that a higher power created our world and us in it. And for those of you who don't believe in religious concepts, I can offer you an alternative reason to believe a higher power is behind this all. God, or the gods, are the programmers of the simulation. Who would make such a masterpiece of a project and not have some sort of hint left behind that they were there? It may be coded into us to worship whoever it is that decided to code us all into existence. In most religious stories, God speaks through people. What if this was actually happening? God is simply the programmer writing their word into the vessel's code to amplify to the rest of the simulation. This would also serve as a great explanation to the story of Mary's Immaculate Conception. If our God, or gods, created our simulation, then it may be plausible that our universe was literally created in 7 days. This would be a very talented coder or a team of coders, but really, it could bring some sense into the story of creation. This could also mean the universe really is only 10,000 years old of our time, and dinosaur remnants are just fake props added to keep us believing time and space is much larger than it actually is. Or, on the other hand, everything we know to be scientifically true about our universe and our creation could be accurate. The coders could have written the Big Bang into existence and watched everything else play its course. While all this may seem quite ridiculous and highly unlikely, the fascinating part of it all is that this theory is impossible to disprove. No one can definitively say it is wrong. So the question turns to this. What do you believe? Thanks for checking out This Sci-Fi. If you like this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications for this channel. Also, check out my last video, 5 Signs Parallel Universes Are Real, and be sure to stay tuned for future sci-fis on all things science and science fiction. I'd also like to give a huge shout out to my new Patreon supporter, Adrian Carrillo. Thank you for making this channel possible.